Hi children, today we are going to do science class 4, uses of plants and animals. I'm Shailija. So let's begin. We see many plants and animals around us. They play an important role in our lives. They also provide us with many things we need in our daily life. We get different products such as food, medicines, fuel, manure, wood, leather, silk, fur, spices, rubber, gum, etc. from them. It is only the plants that prepare the food for all living things on the earth. All animals and human beings, we depend on the plants either directly or indirectly for their food. So uses of plants, let us go there. We get plants. So many uses are there. We get food, oils, wood, perfumes and medicines from the plants. We also get different types of fibers used in the manufacture of clothes and other useful things from the plants. So let us come to the first one, the food grains. Food grains, the seeds of the paddy, rice, wheat, maize, etc. are called cereals. They are called food grains. Cereals are the most important food we get from the plants. They are rich in carbohydrates. So children, whenever your mother prepares chapati or rice, please eat them. It is very good for your health. So these are the food grains which you need and which you are eating daily. The second point we come across are the pulses. Peas, beans and dals like the black gram, Bengal gram, red gram, etc. are all called pulses. They are rich in proteins. So I am sure children, when your mother makes a dal along with your chapati or with your rice, you will be eating it because they have a lot of proteins in it, which gives you very good health for you. So please eat the food prepared by your parent. Next point is oils. We get oils like the coconut oil, groundnut oil, mustard oil, and sunflower oil from the respective plants. Vegetable oils are used in making vanaspati and oils are rich in fats. I am sure you will be using oils. Your mommy will be giving you a lot of fried food also. Good. Your potato fry, it has to be done in oil, deep fried in the oil. You should eat oils also, which is very good for your health. But do not eat too much of oils. It is not very good for your health. You should eat oils, but limited. The next point which we come across are the vegetables. I'm sure you have gone to the market. You have seen the brinjal, lady's finger, bottle gourd, bitter gourd, cabbage, carrot, etc. are some of the vegetables we eat every day. Vegetables are rich in vitamins and mineral salts. So children, whenever your mother makes a curry, do not say, I'm not going to eat it. Vegetables are very, very important for you. It gives you a lot of vitamins and minerals, makes you strong. So please eat the vegetables which is prepared. Next we come across are the fruits. Fruits are rich in vitamins and minerals and water content. They are very tasty and juicy. People of all ages prefer to eat the fruits. Apple, banana, orange, grapes, mango and guava are some of the common fruits. Children, you should eat a fruit daily. At least one fruit you should eat daily. Fruit gives you a lot of vitamin and energy. So please eat at least one single fruit. Go to the market whenever your mother goes, check out all the fruits and vegetables, learn their names also, so that way you can understand and see the fruits. You can ask your mother to prepare a juice also for you. So fruits can be eaten directly or as in the form of juice also. Next, perfumes. Perfume, different kinds of flowers like the jasmine, the rose, the lily, etc. look beautiful. They have a good fragrance. Perfumes are manufactured from them. I'm sure you have sometime taken a rose and smelled it. Lovely smell. Okay, the perfumes are made from these type of flowers. The next we come across is wood. The wood of the teak, the sal and the sagwan plants are used for making furniture. The wood of casuarina and other trees are used as fuel. It is also used in making toys and agricultural implements. Some varieties of wood is also used for making matchsticks, pencils and toothpicks. So I'm sure you are having table, chairs and sofa set in your house. Good children, you are sitting on the wood structure. So wood is used in the form of furniture in your house. Even the doors and the windows are also made of wood. So next we come across, in countries like Japan, and houses are also made of wood. The handles of some of the tools like the hammer, sickle and saw are also made from wood. So now we come across clothes. We get cotton from cotton plant. In the textile industries, cotton is used in manufacturing cloth. It is used to make clothes, towels and bed sheets. Next we come across is medicines. Most of the Ayurvedic medicines are made from various parts of the plants. The eucalyptus and tulsi leaves are also used as medicine for cough and cold. The oil extracted from eucalyptus leaves is used to get relief from headache, cough and cold. Castor oil is also used as a purgative. It is extracted from the seeds of the castor plant. The bark of the cinchona is used in making a medicine for curing malaria disease. The parts of the neem plant also is used as medicine for curing skin diseases. Dhanvantri, Nagarjuna and Charaka were famous ancient experts in Ayurveda. From ancient times, we have been using Ayurvedic medicines in our country. So children, I'm sure you must be having some trees. You must have seen the castor oil plant. Neem plant is very common in everybody's backyard or on the roadside. You have seen the neem leaves also. They are very good in useful as medicines. Next we come across is the manure. Plant waste is also used as manure and is called compost. It helps the plants in their growth. So we have to put some manure for some of the plants for them to grow well and strong and give you a lot of flowers and fruits. So the other uses of the plants. We get coffee, tea and sugar from the plants. We also get economically useful substance like the gum from the acacia, resins from the pine tree, rubber from the rubber trees and paper from the bamboo trees. Trees keep the atmosphere free from pollution. They give out oxygen while preparing their food. So children, grow more plants and trees. The trees give you lot of clean oxygen, clean air to breathe in. It helps you to be healthy. So please plant more trees. Save the earth. Keep the earth as green as possible by growing plants. Next we come across is the uses of animals. Animals play an important role in our lives. They are very useful to us. They can be divided into different types depending on the utility. They are the milk yielding animals which give you milk. Example, cow, sheep, buffalo, etc. Animals whose meat is used as food. Example, goat, fish, sheep, etc. Egg-laying animals. They are the example, hen, duck, etc. Animals useful for agriculture and transport. Example, ox, horse, camel, elephant, etc. So these are the animals which are going to give you so many things. We get the following products from the animals. Milk, eggs and meat, leather, wool and silk, honey, pearls and manure. Let us take milk. Milk is a complete food. We get butter, curd, ghee, etc. from milk. The milk of the goats and camels are also used as food item in some parts of our country. So I'm sure children, everybody is drinking a glass of milk every day. It is very good for your health. When your mother gives you milk, please drink it. Don't say no. Next we come across is the eggs and the meat. Eggs are obtained from the hens and the duck. They are rich in proteins. We get meat from the goats and the chicken, etc. It is rich in proteins and vitamins also. Next we come across is leather. Leather. We get leather from the hides of animals like the goats, sheep, etc. It is used for making belts, bags, shoes and purses. I am sure you are using a belt which is made by leather. So there are so many leather products. wool and silk. Wool is made from the fur of the sheep, yak, etc. It is used in making woolen clothes and caps. We wear woolen clothes during winter season. So I'm sure children, during winter you must be wearing sweaters and woolen caps. Good. Next we come across is silkworms. Silk produces silk fibers, which is made into silk clothes. I'm sure you are having a nice silk dress also. It is very smooth and soft. Honey. Honey is made by honeybees and it is very sweet. It has a great medicinal value. Honeybees also make wax. They use this wax to make their beehives. I'm sure everybody must be using honey in your house also. You can take one spoon of honey. It's very sweet. Next is pearls. Small white color pearls, pink pearls, and so many colored pearls. We get pearls from oysters living in shallow seas. Pearls are very valuable. They are also used for making ornaments like chains, necklaces, earrings. I'm sure you must have seen a small pearl somebody is wearing in your house. Your mother will be wearing it. Manure. Just as the plant waste, animal dung and bones of dead animals are also used to make manure. Manure of animals like the cow dung is used for the plants to make the plants grow healthily. So we always use the cow dung. Farm animals. Certain animals like the ox, horse, etc. are used to work in the farms. Farm animals. Certain animals like the ox, horse, etc. are used to work in the farms. So they are called farm animals. Animals are also useful for transport also. The donkeys, the bullocks, horses, camels, mules and elephants are used for carrying heavy loads. In deep forest, trained elephants are also used to carry heavy logs of wood. Camels are used in the deserts for the transport. So, the camel is called the ship of the desert. I'm sure you have heard about the camels. They carry people and loads from one place to another place in the desert. So, they are called the ship of the desert. Thus, plants and animals play a very important role in our lives. They provide us with many useful things. They are our natural resource. So, we should grow more plants and look after all the animals, children, because they help us to survive in a better way. They give us food and so many things. I'm sure you will learn about the different animals and plants and look after them very well. Thank you. Today, what have we learnt? All animals and human beings depend on green plants for their food. We get food, oils, wood, perfume, medicine, etc. from the plants. Fruits and vegetables contain vitamins and minerals. Dhanvantri, Nagarjuna and Chakra were famous ancient experts in Ayurveda. Plants give us oxygen while preparing their food. We get leather from the hides of some animals. We get pearls from oyster. Plants and animals are our natural resources. So children, today you have gone through the whole lesson. You can pause the lesson, go through it again and again and understand every topic very clearly. Go through the hard words, write them down and check in the Google also for your spellings. Next, after reading the lesson, you have to do the exercise given below the lesson. They are the fill in the blanks and question answers. You can again go back to the lesson, read it again one more time and try to finish all the exercise. I am very sure you can enjoy and complete this lesson in your own time. Thank you.